Already, residents living near King's Cross and St Pancras feel under siege. There are plans to develop the huge derelict site behind the stations, and today saw the launch of a major Mission to Explain campaign. 4 days of debate bringing together all the sides involved for the local people to have their say. But they're now terrified about British Rail plans to bulldoze through a swathe of land, including part of Pentonville Road, if King's Cross is chosen as the site of the second terminal for the Channel Tunnel. That would mean Camley Street Nature Park going and the Bravington's Jewellers Building being put under threat, along with the Scala Cinema. Campaigners say the whole thing has been done in a sneaky manner, with British Rail reacting to leaks rather than being open and above board about the extra development on top of the massive plans already in the pipeline. And with BR lodging a private bill in Parliament tomorrow, which will give them the power to compulsory purchase, residents are becoming increasingly concerned. Even Camden Council are not happy with the way the Channel proposals have been dealt with.
We received very little information from British Rail about their proposals. We have received just a month ago proposals which would involve considerable demolition, including the area I represent, and we would be opposed to that, and we think there are very good grounds not to go ahead with the Channel Tunnel in this area. It could mean overdevelopment of the area, could increase congestion in this area. We're also concerned that it could mean that British Rail will go for a profitable development on this site to pay for the terminal, and that will mean again local people's needs and wishes will be ignored.
British Rail deny they've been secretive.
We put our proposals on display in February at the exhibition in Pancras Road. We have been readily accessible. We've widely advertised how to get in touch with us. We have discussed our proposals with the majority of the people affected. And I'm not prepared to accept that we have been secretive. The difficulty we've had is that until the proposals were finalised, it has been extremely difficult to give people firm answers on the extent to which they, as individuals, would be affected.
And BR say that if the proposals do go ahead, they will not need to demolish all the buildings in the area. The nature park would go, but possibly be restored again afterwards. The Scala Cinema would probably stay, while the facade of Bravington's could be preserved. It's all hardly likely to allay the fears of residents who could see homes and shops razed to the ground if King's Cross is chosen as a Channel Tunnel terminal.